Hi everyone, welcome back to High School Science 101, and today I'm going to show you how to use one of the most important pieces of equipment that we use in our science lab, the Bunsen burner. Let's get started. Before we begin, I just want to take you through some of the main parts of our Bunsen burner. We have the barrel, we have the collar, which you can rotate to open and close a little air hole. We have the base, we have the gas inlet, and we have the gas hose, which is usually a rubber or silicon material. Once you've set up your Bunsen burner, inspect your hose for any kinks or holes or wear and tear, and if you're happy with it, plug it onto your tap nice and securely. And most gas taps supply propane, but if your lab or your school uses a different type of gas for your Bunsen burners, let me know in the comments. I also just want to explain some of the safety equipment that you should have with you when you're using a Bunsen burner. That includes your safety glasses, and it also includes your lab coat. And your lab coat should have press studs as its method of doing up. And these press studs are really important because if your lab coat does catch fire, if there's some sort of emergency and you have to get this off really quickly, the press studs will allow you to take it off as quickly as possible. Also ensure that you've gathered all of the other equipment that you'll need for this experiment as well. That could include your heatproof mat, but also a gauze mat and a tripod if you're heating up things such as beakers, and also a peg if you want to hold something above the flame. We're about to light the Bunsen burner, and we need to firstly ensure that this air hole is closed, that you can't see through this hole in the collar. If we turn the collar, we can see that we open the air hole, and we'll use that later on when we're heating things up. But for now, when we're lighting it, we ensure that the air hole is closed. I've checked that my air hole is closed, it's on a heatproof mat, and my gas hose is securely fastened to our gas tap, and the gas is turned off. I'm now ready to light the Bunsen burner. So I'll light my match, hold it about 1 centimeter above our barrel, and slowly turn the gas on. And once I can see that it's lit, I can take the match away and extinguish it. And the flame should be yellow, and this is our safety flame. It's less hot than the alternative flame that I'll show you, but this is used when we're lighting the Bunsen burner and also if we have to leave the Bunsen burner unattended. I can now rotate the collar to open up the air hole, and in doing so, I'm allowing more oxygen into that flame and the flame gets much hotter. It's now a blue flame, barely visible blue flame, and this is the flame that we would use for heating things up. Again, if we want to leave the Bunsen burner unattended for whatever reason, we would switch it back over to the yellow flame, which is sometimes called our safety flame because A, it's less hot, and B, it's much easier to see. Okay, so now I've completed my experiment and I'm ready to turn my Bunsen burner off. What you don't do is blow it out. The safest way to extinguish the Bunsen burner is to turn your gas tap off, and that cuts off the supply of propane to your Bunsen burner. Sometimes when you're using your Bunsen burner, it might just go off. If you're switching between open and closed air hole, for example, or just if there's a bubble in the gas supply. If that ever happens, don't panic. Just turn your gas off and then go through the start procedure again. And that's it for today. We've gone through some of the key parts of the burner, how to safely connect it and inspect it, as well as some of the safety equipment and how to safely light and use our Bunsen burner. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you get a lot of use out of your Bunsen burner.